Hi everyone, and welcome to Mornings with Arbrenne. Today on the show, I want to talk about the word perseverance. So, perseverance is when someone perseveres through something. When they try as hard as they can over and over and over again, despite failure. Okay, so many of you know I am a rock climber and love rock climbing. I'm wearing my shirt from my gym of rock climbing. And when I'm rock climbing, what I do over and over again is I fail. I fall. I fall in a controlled, safe way so I'm not hurt, but I fall over and over again. And the way that I persevere is I get back up on the wall and I climb again and again. So today I want to do two things. One, I want to show you a video of me rock climbing. I took it last year when we were still at the gym. And this video shows me falling over and over and over again. And what I do is I get back up, I get back on the wall, and I get better and better. And the second thing I want to do is I want to do a read aloud of a new book by a really famous rock climber. And her name is Ashima. And Ashima is especially famous because she got to be a professional rock climber when she was a kid. She started climbing when she was 6, and she got really famous when she was 8. And then even more famous as she got older. So she's only 19 now, and she's one of the best rock climbers in the world. And she has been since she was a child. So I want to show you my rock climbing video, and then I'm going to do a read aloud of that book. And when you're watching both videos, I want you to be thinking about, how is this person persevering? How are they working through something really hard? How are they getting back up? And keep trying it, okay? This week we're gonna read another book as a class called Brave Irene by William Steig. And Irene also perseveres, so we're gonna be talking about it there too. Thank you.
How to Solve a Problem, The Rise and Falls of a Rock Climbing Champion by Ashima Shirashi. Illustrations by Yao Xiao. Sorry if I pronounced any of that wrong. I am Ashima. What I do is climb. What I do is solve problems, which is to say, I make them mine. We climbers call our boulders problems. We also call our problems problems, and to solve them both is sort of the same. Once I had a problem, and it stretched into the sky, and it was tremendously endless. It was bigger than thinking. It was as huge as the air or the night or the planet. It was a problem bigger than any I had ever seen, and I have seen plenty. There were twists and turns. There were places that looked as slick as glass. One part was arced like a question mark. Another part stuck out like my father's elbow in a photo I have seen of him dancing. And another was shaped like the bolts of fabric stacked in my mother's sewing room. There were many parts, and none of them looked easy. I sighed and clapped my hands full of chalk, which is what I do before I solve a problem. I held this problem in my head. I mapped out every step, each place I would put my hand, and then I began to climb. Dug my toe into the dot of the question mark, jammed my fingertips into the bend of my father's dancing elbow, kicked my leg over my mother's fabrics. And then for a moment, the world slipped out from under me. I was climbing on nothing but air. The ground beneath me rushed up and pressed into my back like the hand of a giant named Gravity. So I dusted myself off. Dad asked how I was feeling. He passed me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and for a while we just sat there. Then when I was ready, I looked at the problem again, with the new information the fall had given me. Each fall is a message, a hint, an idea, a new way to move from over there to over here. And so I started. And so I fell. And so I climbed again, listening to what the fall had told me. The problem that was endless, which I broke into little pieces. The problem that gave me hints with each fall. And surely and quickly, I climbed the wall. I dug my fingers there and here, and stretched my arms like ropes. I threw my body through the air and caught myself in all the ways I'd imagined, a bright path of thinking. And there at the top of the problem, I looked down at the bolts of fabric, the dot of the question mark, the bend of the elbow, and I waved hello at the memory of how hard the problem was. And looked for one problem more. And here's the author, Ashima, and the illustrator, Yao.